Welcome back to our channel. Here we are again with another video on Algal Member. I started to make videos on workout series. Please check it out. We have Insta account and Facebook page as well. You could follow us there too for daily posts. So moving forward, let's learn. Gilbert Morgan Smith or G.M. Smith classified algae into 7 divisions mainly. Each division contains one or more classes. The first division is Chlorophyta, which contain 2 classes. Class 1 is Chlorophyce and class 2 is Charophyce. We are going to learn about vegetative structure of one member of Chlorophyce today. In our next video, we will learn its reproductive structure and the process. Okay, first introduce ourselves with some common visible features. The class Chlorophyce. Most freshwater green algae include into this category, and there are few marine algae. An algal plant body contains both simple and complex type. Vegetative body may be unicellular, colonial or multicellular. All members are associated with chlorophyll, carotenoids, pigments, and hence a grass green color is produced. Let's see which specimen I have. It is a species of Edogonium. Let's have a quick look of its classification. Edogonium belongs to the family Edogoniaceae. Order Edogonial is class Chlorophyce and division Chlorophyta. Edogonium is a submerged aquatic filamentous green alga found to occur in quite permanent and semi-permanent fresh water of pools, gills, tanks, ditches. All species are sessile when young, that is found attached to various substrates underwater, usually as epiphytes upon stems and leaves of aquatic angiosperms or upon other filamentous green alga. Now I will be describing its vegetative structure with live specimen workout. It is as simple as Nostoc workout. Please check it out in our previous video. Preparing a grease-free glass slide, teasing apart clotted filaments a little bit, staining with cotton blue and let it fix for a few moments. Here we have some satisfactory images to describe its thallus structure. The plant body is an unbranched filamentous thallus which consists of cylindrical cells joined end to end. The mature filament is differentiated into base and apex and consists of vegetative cells. The basal cell is always modified to form a disc-like and a colorless holdfast, by means of which the plant remains attached to the substratum underwater. The distal, that is apical cell, is generally broadly rounded or acuminate. The vegetative cells are provided with a thick rigid wall. The lateral wall of such a cell is composed of 3 layers: outermost chitinous layer, a middle pectic layer, and inner cellulosic layer. Lateral walls of some cells of each filament have one or more ring-like markings at the distal end. Those are called capsules or apical caps. Each cell contains dense granular cytoplasm and a single large biscuit-shaped nucleus having a well-defined chromatin lining network and one or more nucleoli. The nucleus remains embedded in the cytoplasm at one corner and just internal to the chloroplast. Numerous pyrenoids lie at the intersections of the chloroplast reticulum, and each pyrenoid is surrounded by a sheath of starch granules. These starch granules from the pyrenoids may migrate to and accumulate in the strands of the chloroplast net until the reticulate of the chloroplast is totally obscured. Such a structure is known as stroma starch. The mode of cell division resulting in the production of a cap. With the migration of the nucleus towards the distal end of the cell division starts. The nucleus then divides mitotically and simultaneously. There appears a ring of wall materials which encircles the inner face of the lateral wall just below the distal end of the cell. The division of the nucleus is followed by the appearance of a septum in between the two daughter nuclei. the septum remains floating for some time without being connected with the lateral wall. The protoplast soon elongates, as a result of which the newly formed ring on the lateral wall is stretched, resulting in the breaking of the lateral wall in the transverse direction at the level of the ring. The ring becomes stretched further to form a new wall. Although a little of the original wall remains at the upper end of the cell and is known as cap. Often an individual cell may undergo several successive divisions, each leaving a characteristic cap, and the number of which will denote the number of divisions the cell has undergone. There are two more important structures we need to learn about is oogonium and antheridium, the reproductive structures of this filamentous body. Based on these structures, there are two types of oogonium species, the macrandrous type and the nanandrous type. As I said at very beginning of this video, we will learn about the reproductive structure and the reproduction of oogonium in our next video. So stay with us. We will be back soon. Thank you for your patience.